If the recent hurricane season has taught us anything, it's that preparation is the key to coordinating an effective response. And preparation involves training, disaster training to be exact. Recently, the Chippewa Valley School District reached out to Clinton Township Fire, Police, and EMS to help simulate several training exercises involving a crashed and smoking school bus. To date, there's never been a serious accident involving a Chippewa Valley school bus, but the district believes in being prepared, especially with their drivers being responsible for the safety of more than 11,000 students who travel on buses each day. Clinton Township Fire Training Chief Tom Stuck saw it as an opportunity to support the school district and get township firefighters some hands-on training as well.
We're here to support the bus drivers initiative for their in-service training, which they go through every year, getting prepared for the school year. And we wanted to come out and help support them. We managed to gather a couple of our partners in care, MedStar Ambulance, and in a little bit we're gonna have Survival Flight come in to help support the big exercise that we're gonna do, which is the catastrophic event of a car versus bus with multiple patients. So we're gonna be doing that. So the Chippewa Valley Transportation Department was nice enough to help us facilitate the training. We also have to thank the Roseville Transportation Department for donating the bus that we're gonna be using later on, and Ruley's Towing for coming out and help us set up the scene. They've all done a great job for us, and it's really been fun working with them behind the scenes.
From the township's perspective, the fire department is mandated to conduct disaster training on an annual basis. Chief Stuck explains.
As a matter of fact, we will be having one of the members of the MCA, which is the Medical Control Authority here in Macomb County. He's going to stop by later on because as a fire department, as a life support agency, we are responsible for holding at least one drill per year. Now we get involved in multiple drills because we enjoy drilling like that. It gives a little bit of a legitimacy to what we do every day. We come out and drill and we practice, and so we're ready for the big one. And so that's what we're doing out here today.
The first part of the training involves how to properly evacuate a smoke-filled bus. The smoke being used is called fire and rescue fog. It's made from a water-based fluid formulated to create the perfect smoke for simulated smoke training. Chief Stuck has seen very few bus accidents over the course of his long career. That speaks to the good driving skills of the bus drivers, but also to their safety training as well.
Actually, bus accidents are not common. 24 plus years in pre-hospital healthcare myself, and I can only think of probably three that I was involved in. We don't see a lot of it because of training like this. The bus drivers come out, they train rigorously, and they're prepared to take your children to school safely. And I think that's great. But in the event of an accident like that, we hope that we can minimize its impact.
More than a dozen students volunteered to be made up to look like accident victims for the simulation. Disturbing details like this help everyone to prepare for what they might see at a real accident scene. Brendan Wagner is the director of pupil transportation with Chippewa Valley. He explained the other aspects of the safety training for the school bus drivers.
This is our annual in-service that we do for our driving staff. And today what we're doing is we have one group that's working on wheelchair safety training. We have another group that's working on our new protocol for pre- and post-trip inspections of school buses. And then we have another group that is doing like a smokehouse. They have smoke buses. So where the fire department has come out, they're filling buses with smoke, and the bus drivers are learning how to evacuate a bus when it's smoke filled. They're going to run, do the round at each of the stations. So this is strictly for our bus drivers, school bus drivers.
Wagner agreed that in a way, the frontline training is helping the bus drivers to react more like first responders should they find themselves in a real emergency.
And we talk about it all the time. We talk about what ifs. We have our training guides. We have protocol in writing. We have discussions, but this is the first time that we've actually had an opportunity for the drivers to experience the what if. So now they know what a smoke-filled bus looks like, feels like, and what they're going to have to do if they're in that situation.
A lot of the credit for the creativity of the training and the relationship forged with township first responders went to new transportation coordinator Patty Broll.
Yeah, this is the start of, I think, a beautiful relationship with Fire Rescue from Clinton Township. We've had a passing cordial, you know, relationship, but this Patty Broll has jumped right in and formed a bond, and so I think this is the first of many of these types of training opportunities for both of us, because both departments are benefiting from this.
The second part of the training began with the help of Ruley's Towing. Ruley's turned a donated bus that was going out of commission on its side and on top of a compact car, complete with injured passengers. Simulated, of course. Firefighters took their time in the training exercise to make sure everyone got a hands-on feel for what had to be done. To make vehicle extraction more realistic, a few students got inside the bus and the crushed car, while others scattered throughout the parking lot. Getting the students involved went beyond the basic evacuation drills done every year. They were all too glad to give the scene a more realistic look by using fake blood on their arms, legs, and heads. And even though a situation arose to prevent the helicopter from making an appearance, the day's training was time well spent. It showed the bus drivers and students what first responders do in a situation like a crash. Having the school district, fire, police, and EMS come together for the training was a positive thing for the entire community.